Hi guys, welcome to this quick tutorial where I'm gonna show you how to stream your voice with edit effects on the internet. Here we go! As you can see, I use Bidwig to add effects to my voice. You can use any other DAW to do that. Important is, Bidwig uses the ASIO driver, and we will come back to that later when it comes to our DirectWIRE settings. So here I added a little reverb and a delay to my voice, so my voice sounds like in a cave. Yep, that's what it sounds like. By the way, if you wonder how to get there, like setting up your interface and microphone and adding effects on Bidwig, check out our how-to voice recording video on YouTube to learn all about these steps in detail. Of course, you can use any effect you like, and you can not only use your voice as an input, but also any instrument like your keyboard or guitar. So you could even perform a whole song right here and stream that live on the internet. Now I want to stream this voice with the effects so that people can hear my altered voice. And to do so, I have to adjust a few settings. First, I changed the default device. I opened the control panel of my interface, which is the U22XT, and select the Windows audio settings under File. Now the sound dialog of the Windows control panel opens. Under Playback, the default device can be adjusted. And since I have a two-channel device, I use the virtual channels 3-4. Don't forget to press Set Default and then OK. Now we head over to our DirectWIRE panel. And this is my wiring. So, why did I do that? Well, you know that Bidwig is using the ASIO driver and the signal with the effects is being played out on channel 1-2. I want to send this signal to my virtual channels WDMMME channels 3-4. WDMMME is used by Zoom or Skype or many other voice over IP services. But also, most other online streaming services use either WDM or MME. So this is where I want my signal to be. Make sure to enable mix 3-4 to 1-2 so that you are able to listen to the conversation and your own altered voice in the call as well. On a multi-channel hardware, this setting is not needed. Now you only need to adjust your settings in Zoom or your other streaming service. The first thing to test is whether you can hear the sound from the system you are connected to. And when it comes to testing your microphone, you must make sure your setting is U22XT channel 3-4. And now you speak and pause. So this is what it sounds like. There you are. It's only a few clicks with DirectWIRE by ESI, so make sure to get your ESI audio interface today, since only ESI hardware is DirectWIRE enabled. Have fun streaming!